there. So as we all wait for a vaccine, there are still many people waiting to try and be tested for the virus. Tonight, 7 Eyewitness News senior reporter Eileen Buckley takes a look at what's being done to try and cut down on this backlog.
Took 20 days, one day short of 3 weeks.
Joanne Almer of Hamburg says she wasn't feeling well, so her doctor ordered COVID tests for Almer and her husband. They went through a drive-thru where you administer the test yourself, but Quest Labs provided the results. Almer was told she would get results in 3 to 5 days, but that didn't happen.
Made me feel sicker, really, you know, because we were so stressed.
Nearly 3 weeks later, after quarantining for 2 weeks, Almer says she found out she was negative. She was frustrated, especially when she heard how quickly NFL players are tested for COVID.
But because they're pro football players or whatever, it was frustrating. It made me angry. I was very angry.
The Erie County Health Department is experiencing a high demand for COVID tests. The county says there's no average wait time, but they book 3 to 5 days out. A spokeswoman for the health department says right now, appointments for diagnostic test sites are filled, but more appointments should open later this week. There are other testing sites available, and you can find them on this pop-up map on the health department's website. Erie County Executive Mark Polenkar says the county only conducts 1,500 of the 40,000 tests conducted each week across the region. He says it's best to call your doctor first.
And your doctor might be able to write a prescription to you to get a test at a lab that could be closer to your house than actually anything that the county offers.
But waiting for test results is another trouble spot. This tweet was in response to the county executive. It stated, here's some data. On my 10-day of isolation, I found out I was positive 6 days ago. Still no call from contact tracers. Nice job. On Monday, Health Commissioner Dr. Gail Burstein apologized for delays in the notification process, admitting some people waited too long before finding out they tested positive.
And I want to personally apologize for that. The buck stops here.
Eileen Buckley, 7 Eyewitness News.